is Sunday afternoon, August 8th, and I got some very exciting mail, and I'm very excited to show you guys.
Questions? Okay, you gotta go fast because my arm's getting sore.
Okay. All right, so this is the secret gift, the paperback. They say that you can just rip this, but there we go. Oh, I should have said this. It's from KDP, so it has a bar right across her face, which I knew that.
Check it out. Isn't it pretty?
Here's the back. Very snazzy. Very nice. Here's the spine. Just ignore the KDP bar, because it's literally across her eyes. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
So dumb. I wish they'd get rid of that. And this is like a temporary barcode, but they get rid of that too. And it's all the way across the back. Let's check it out. Here's the inside. Woo! Looks so pretty, doesn't it? Check it out. I put this in the back. A little excerpt to the Stolen Kingdom series. Isn't that cool?
It's nice, yes.
And then there's like a chapter from the Stolen Kingdom. And that's it.
How many are you gonna sell?
How many am I gonna sell? Thousands.
Better.
Thanks, babe.
Cool.
Yay. There it is. Oh my gosh. I kind of said this already in my little unboxing, but when I ordered the proof, I could obviously see the preview, I guess, is what I'm trying to say, where it goes straight across her eyes. And I was telling my friends, I was like, this is such a bummer that KDP does this, because I mean, I ordered this for proof reading to do my final pass of the story. And so I'm just going to be reading it. Like, it doesn't have to be perfect on the outside, but man, if it didn't look like this, I would also take a lot more pictures of it. You know what I mean? I just love that it's got a lot of like innocence to it, but it also has that hint of things are about to go very wrong. You know, it just, it really says what the story is about, which is really fun. Mandy did try to put a girl, this girl, on the spine like the other books, but of course, as you can see, it's still pretty skinny, but this is a hefty book. Like, let me show you. Oh, I'll give you a Prego update in a minute too, but first of all, here is this series. You guys know, obviously, that the paperbacks are still available with these original covers, and The Curse Hunter right here is a novella. And let me just show you. There we go. It's like exactly the same. Isn't that crazy? So this is, let me just, you know, shout out my formatting videos in case you didn't know that I have a whole series on it, but this is 50,000 words. This is 31,000. So this is what you can do with the magic of formatting. Man, I just love that spine. It's just, ooh, I love it. I love it. It's perfect. So, okay, I'm getting a little distracted. Let me show you the difference in the font size here. First chapter compared to that. So obviously, let's see if I can hold them up at the same time to really give you that visual. Oh yeah, you can tell. And it's just little things, you know, the chapter header is a little higher up on the page right there. And that can add up things like that. That's all it takes. I actually added more pages. So I am going to have Mandy make me a final spine that's even bigger than this. It's gonna be more than 184, but I didn't want to be that client who's asking for constant changes. So instead of doing that, I just was like, you know what? This is just the proof copy. I'm here to proofread it. So I removed some of the extra pages and I just bunched everything together in the front. But what I want to do is I like when the very first page is just the title and then you turn the page and the copyright's usually next. And then I like when there's another title page. So I'm probably gonna do like this more with more info on this side. And then I like having a blank page and then this also by, and then another blank page, and then the sign up for my author newsletter here, and then another blank page on the left, because usually chapter one will have a blank page on this side. So I hope that makes sense. I'm going to tweak the front more once I know my final page count after I've proofread, and I'll tell Mandy this is the final spine. And so in case you're curious, you might not be that curious about this, but cover design isn't done until the last minute because of this spine, because when you make changes to formatting, it changes the cover as well. So that's why Mandy and I wouldn't consider the cover completely done yet, but I did want to actually hold it and see the cover in person. And I just love it. I love it so much. If only this didn't cover her eyes, because I feel like that shifty look she has right there, it is so, so perfect. So that's what I'll be working on this week, and hopefully I'll finish proofreading by the end of the week and have a final book. And I'm going to be sending early reader copies to my patrons tomorrow, and then I think I'll set up an ARC sign up, maybe just through my newsletter. Most likely I will let my newsletter know and stick to that because I don't want to send a ton of ARCs, but I do want to send some. And I'm thinking of maybe trying out Story Origin for ARC since I've never tried that before. See if it makes the process a little bit smoother. Yeah, it's just crazy because, let's see, today is the 8th, so yesterday was a month to release. So we're getting very close, but it's basically going to be done by the end of the week. So depending on Mandy's schedule, I'll finish proofreading, I'll give her the final page count for the spine, she'll fix the cover, and then I'll probably order a nicer version without this barcode across the cover. A final proof, just so I can also check that and have it for marketing purposes and for enjoyment purposes, I guess, to see my own finished work, and it'll be done. But let me pause in this for a second and take you over to my YouTube dashboard here. This is the latest video I just did where I announced, obviously, the exciting news about little baby Atezada. Actually, let me go back and point this out to you because this is wild to me. This is over 2,000 views and it just went public a couple days ago, and then right here, 265 comments, you guys. And I was answering them in the morning and in the afternoon and in the evening on the day that it launched. Like, that's more than I normally have time to do, but I was like, oh my gosh, I want to say thank you to everybody. But then I fell behind. I had so many other things I had to do. I have two other big projects that I closed out yesterday. They're bookish related projects that I can't tell you about just yet, but I just wrapped them up and I was like trying really hard to meet a deadline. So I was like, okay, I have to stop answering YouTube comments because I have to get this done. And then I would come back and there'd be dozens more. Overwhelmed by all the love. So basically I wanted to say in this video, this is sort of impromptu, I just wanted to come and say thank you. And I've been seeing all your comments. They've been coming in, I've been enjoying them and tearing up a little bit. And in case I don't get a chance to answer everybody, thank you. It means so, so, so much to us and it's been so encouraging. It blew my mind that so many people, let me go to the comments here. So this is just the comments that it says right here at the top I haven't responded to yet, so I can sort that and that way I can make sure that I'm catching everybody on the back end. But again, let me just show you, these are all the comments that I haven't answered yet in the back end. It just keeps going. You guys are amazing. Like, I answered a lot too. So like I said, you guys blew me out of the water. I was not expecting that. And then on top of that, on Instagram, I shared this picture, which I'll put on the screen here nicer, but look at that. It's just, wow, it's amazing. And all those comments, I'm very thankful for you guys. I really appreciate you more than you know. And what really encouraged me, especially about the YouTube comments, because I think YouTube just lets you write more than you can fit in something like this. And I've also gotten probably 20 plus emails and 20 plus messages from Instagram from you guys saying, like, I've been there. I know how you feel. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but I haven't actually answered any of these emails either yet because it was so overwhelming to me in a good way, but it was still just like, wow. I thought I was completely alone in feeling this way. And then there's just hundreds of people telling me that they've been there. They understand that it's normal, that it passes, that it is still doable. And I have come to that conclusion myself, but it's very encouraging to also hear it repeated over and over and have people be like, no, you've got this. So anyway, I just wanted to say I appreciate you guys so, so much. And I had intended to put out a video this week on my beta reader process and an update. And maybe I'll do like two videos next week or something because I have a video after that already recorded. So the next two videos I've already recorded. And then after all the love on that last video, I was like, I think I need to say thank you. I think I need to say something specifically to all of you who commented and who watched and support me and just say thank you, thank you, thank you, because it made my day, made my week, and I appreciate you guys more than you know. So anyway, back to it. Let's do a little bump date, why not? This is our bump date right now. and I'm feeling awesome. Eating all the time, you know how it is. This is 22 weeks and 4 days, and they are giving me, I think this is funny, a water bottle. Just like every other size comparison this app gives is super unhelpful, because water bottles come in every shape and size. So I just laugh at that.
You are still my baby.
Oh, you're okay. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Wow. Wow. That's so nice of you. Don't worry, you're still my baby too. Mama loves you. So that's where I'm at. I've got my bullet journal. I'm starting to fill it out for next week to figure out what to do. And it's gonna be a little intense. I've got that project that I told you I wrapped it up. So now I'm going back into another round of edits, trying to really knock it out. It's going to be a project for most of this month. It's gonna be pretty intensive, but it'll be good to get it done. And then of course, I'm gonna be proofreading this beautiful book. This, if I was reading it for fun, it would probably be about a 2-hour read for me, because I read really fast. It has 10 chapters, but I'm thinking, just based on my past proofreading, I'm gonna guesstimate maybe 2-ish days. And if you're curious how I do proofreading, I do have a video on that. I have a video on like everything now, right? I can't believe I forgot to say this the first time around, but obviously this is officially available as a paperback. And I have been watching the sites. I've been kind of sneakily telling everyone on Instagram. So if you follow me there, you probably already saw the news, but it is for sure live on Barnes & Noble. It is for sure live on Target. And I will let you know on Instagram when the Amazon one becomes available. It's there. It's just not actually letting you buy it yet. They're still processing as they do, because Amazon and IngramSpark are kind of competitors. So they don't always play well together. And sometimes you have to wait a little bit for the book to go live. But oh my gosh, how could I not remember to tell you that yes, it is officially available for you to buy as a paperback as well. This is not just for me. This is me reading it, checking the formatting, making sure it's good for you guys to get in the mail in less than a month. Okay, back to what I was saying. I don't think I said this in my other video, but I am making it a priority these days to exercise every single day, whether it's just going for a walk or using the elliptical or both, because when I do that, I feel so much better than the days that I don't. I sleep better. I just don't feel as sick. I mean, I don't usually feel sick these days, but I just have to say that I should have made this a habit sooner, because it just helps my day be so much better. So I'm going to be prioritizing those things, as well as sending IRCs. I call them IRCs because they're not advanced review copies. They are early reader copies, which means they are a gift to all of my patrons for supporting me. So I'll be working on those, and I will then move into IRCs once the book is proofread. And I guess then I'll move into marketing, and that'll be very fun. I'm very, very excited for some of the plans that I have. It is rushed, but now you guys know why, because baby A is coming, and I didn't want to have this unfinished. I wanted this to be out in the world and be able to see one more book published before baby comes. And actually, I'm just going to give you a little hint. This might not be the last one before baby comes. But that's all I'm going to hint at. So until next time, I hope you guys enjoyed this little update, and I will see you again very soon. Bye.